Where would that happen?
Florida, where the, you know, we went down there for the Christmas holiday. We got an in-law with an extra house. It was pretty warm, it was like low to mid-80s. But for that time of year, I guess it's pretty hot.
Can't complain too much about this winter here though, can you? It's been too bad.
I wish we had more, get more snow.
Yeah, it's dry.
Joe won't be here and Thomas won't be here, but... I have to go into executive session to talk about that.
Mr. Benson, when you need legal counsel, do you use the city's counsel or do you have your own?
Depending on, we use the cities for some things and we have other counsel for other, depending on the, what it is we need counsel for.
Land title specialists and this and that.
Okay. Yeah, we got one that we rely on for the low-income housing tax credit program and then we've got a couple of other consultants.
Where are they out of? Want to say Twitchell or Vogel or?
Well, one's out of Minneapolis and one's out of Boston.
Wow.
You know, Boston Legal.
Boston Legal.
Right. Yeah.
Hi there.
I'm jealous.
Very jealous.
He dropped you.
It's good. It's good.
Hi there.
Chase any fish?
A friend of my son, who's like my, I thought instead of my stuff just sitting in our own garage, you know, after so long, it was going to go bad and everything rust and everything. He's going to melt a lot. So he's pretty happy I did that.
Actually, the thing that I'm looking for most,
trying to find something.
We'll get through all of this and then go into.
Yeah, lunch. Get my, sonar.
Next one, get all sound and then part off. I had two, I thought you were one, you were one.
The doctor is serious.
Get my rod and stuff too.
You did talk to the city?
Yep, yep.
Do we need to, all right, well, let's call the meeting to order. We do have a quorum, so Bryce is coming now, yes?
Yes.
And you're all set?
Yeah.
Okay, let's call the meeting to order. And first thing, why don't we maybe just go around and introduce ourselves? There's some faces here. Hi Bryce, I'm Karen Moore.
Ken Presta.
Bryce, do you want to just?
Bryce Johnson.
Hi.
Tana Horsley.
Hello.
My name's Mike Lear.
Ashley Burgum, I'm in section eight.
Steve Eichhoff, I'm the capital improvements coordinator.
Scott Neskey, finance manager.
Lynn Fundingland, executive director.
And Sarah Jerome, HR manager.
Okay. And you, sir?
Oh, my name's Joe. I'm just Joe Q Public, I guess.
Wow.
Interested in what goes on in meetings like this.
That's wonderful.
I'm Mark Nelson. And I had the pleasure of living in the tower in some years past, and it's a good experience, and yes, indeed.
Well, welcome to you all.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much.
Tracy Alunek, I work in accounting with Scott.
Okay. Wonderful. Well, all right. Has everybody had a chance to go over the consent agenda?
I had one thing on the consent agenda.
Okay, let's do, to the consent agenda next.
In April, the annual Washington conference to meet our congressional delegation and people, 15% one representative.
So adding to the consent agenda, we are looking for approval for one person to go to the Washington NARO conference.
April.
Yeah, in April.
So then will we have one person going?
Well, it's open to others. I can tell you, I should have put it eight.
No, I'm not interested in going, but historically.
One staff or one including the board or?
Well, we'll have another opportunity. It's April 10th. If we register now, we get a discount. If we register after the next board meeting, I'm not sure if we get a discount. But I think historically it's something that any board members encouraged to attend. I think of having a board person there is a lot more, there's a lot more weight than the staff. So. And it's April 10 through 13.
It's like this.
My question was, usually you wear the Bill Thomas coat. That's why I was wondering, really requesting one person.
Well, maybe, good point. Let's modify it up to three.
Up to three. All right. Okay.
As a board member, I've gone to Washington once, and I found those meetings less informative for board members than the national conference or the summer conference. So.
I think the real value is connecting with our congressional delegation. Yeah. I don't know what our concerns are here.
Having your board members there.
Yeah.
Display for that.
Yep.
Big display.
So if a board member is interested and is able to go, can we, when do we need to let you know by?
When is the?
When's the early?
No, it doesn't say when the cutoff is for early registration.
Should we just say end of February?
And or if you would, maybe if you wouldn't mind, send an email out to everybody saying, and we can check then when the early bird registration is done.
Early birds up until February 26th.
Okay. So before February 26th. Okay. Is there a motion to approve the consent agenda?
So moved. Second.
Okay. Are there any changes? Questions? If not, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Any changes to the agenda other than executive session?
No.
Okay. All right. Well, let's go into reports. I don't know which you two would like to go first.
I can go first, Karen, because I don't have a whole lot.
And I have less.
All right.
The only thing that we're still, as far as the capital, is we're still waiting. The ACC amendments haven't come out from HUD yet, so we don't know what level we'll have for 16. I have all the other documents together. I'm just waiting for that. We can't submit until I have that amendment, so.
Till you have for year 16, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And do we have any idea when that's gonna come?
Whenever they get around to it.
Lovely.
Like, every year.
I know.
They're like, I don't know, they're about a month behind on the one thing I have to do, so.
I'm gonna guess probably March, hopefully.
And what's the RFQ for architectural and engineering services? What's the RFP?
RFP, request for qualifications.
Qualifications, gotcha. Just wanted, I wasn't sure when that comes.
I can explain that.
Any other questions? Thank you so much.
And really, the only thing I have in there is just the list of the checks we've paid and the credit card bill. The rest of it is a little bit behind because we're short one person in accounting. We had someone leave, so we're juggling a little bit right now.
And then we brought a temp in and she just didn't quite work out. Didn't have to school. So we're having another temp.
Yeah, coming on Tuesday. We've come to talk. Hello.
Do you know why?
Money. She wouldn't even tell me how much it would pay, so I tried.
All right. Okay, so we'll be looking for those next month then.
Yep.
Okay. Let's move on to old business. Update on the RAD project.
All right, well, we're getting close to an application being put together for New Horizons and Pioneer Manor. We've met with tenants from both buildings, had a pretty good turnout. I guess I did a count, I can't remember what we had, but we had 50-odd people at New Horizons and probably 40 at Pioneer Manor. It's pretty lively discussions, a lot of questions at both buildings. So we have, that was one of the requirements. HUD has to give it a notification. So we're probably over a year away from doing the rehab in those buildings, but the tenants were appreciative of getting a long heads up on that. Kind of the strategy is to do Pioneer first, where we only have to vacate 6 units to do it. And then once we are most of the way through that, we're starting the outdoor things on New Horizons. New Horizons, we have to have 18 vacancies to do the rehab there.
How many vacancies?
18.
18, okay.
Yeah, and both buildings are really slow turnover. I mean, Pioneer, we turn over about 6 a year. And New Horizons, I'm not, isn't proportionally about the same, very, very low turnover. So once we get the approval, we'll start to, as we get a turnover, we'll not re-rent that unit. So we try to avoid having to rehouse someone off-site, so instead we'll rotate people within the building as the plan. So,
if you got to rehouse them, how long are they out for? Does that vary?
It's a month to two.
Okay.
Yeah, big hassle for everybody,
yeah,
but it's,
yeah,
don't see a way around it. The extent of the renovations require it, we're gonna lose the bathroom, we're gonna lose the kitchen, and it's pretty disruptive. So try to live in that. Well, the code won't let us do that. So we got both of those tenant groups are made aware of what's going on, and we'll meet with them periodically as we get closer to the actual rehab. I don't know, Steve, what else we have? The tenants have to get a formal letter from us, which hasn't been sent out yet, which we do here shortly. We needed a conditional commitment from a lender and from an equity provider for the tax credits. We've got Wells Fargo has agreed to provide those letters, so that's done. I think by the end of the month, we should have our application ready to submit. It requires formal approval from the board. And so that's what we're requesting of you today, to put those two projects into the RAD program. If we could get a motion to that effect, if you have any other questions about it. It's about $3.5 million worth of improvements in each building. Or not each building, but the buildings combined.
So, then in terms of the procedure, when we give approval to move forward, will the next step then be waiting for approval from HUD?
No.
And after that, when does our relationship or whoever our partner is in the process, when does that start? Or when do we do an RFP for that? Or what
well, we've got an RFP for that. Yeah. We got a response from DSI.
Okay, so that is it.
We need to negotiate what that partnership can look like. I think rather than terming a partnership, I think we would hire them to do consulting for us. On an hourly basis, yeah, is what I suggest.
I guess I knew we had done that. I just wasn't sure if we've got a formal agreement at this point.
We put out an RFP and got a formal response.
Right. Yeah, I know.
And now we need to negotiate terms.
Okay.
That's the question I
wanted to get to at that point, though, on the negotiations of the specifics of how that agreement will look.
Right. And I can tell you, their proposal was...